everyone. Welcome to our channel, Biology for All. In this video, I'm going to show you how to draw and label the human digestive system. We first draw double lines representing the oral cavity and the esophagus, and then draw a J-shaped structure, that is the stomach, and then extend to form a C-shaped region, that is the duodenum. Now we have to draw the large intestine and the small intestine. So we begin by drawing the large intestine, making this kind of a framework, and inside that we are going to draw the small intestine. So here now I extend that part and I am starting to draw double line here in a zigzag manner to show the compactly arranged small intestine. This then joins with the large intestine there, forming an extension, that is the appendix. Now let us draw the accessory glands. So here we begin by drawing the liver on the stomach and then drawing the gallbladder. Next to that, between the small intestine and the stomach is the pancreas, and in the oral cavity is the salivary gland. Let's now start labeling the diagram. So here the first part is the buccal cavity, or we call that also as the oral cavity, which then leads to this long tube-like structure, that is the esophagus, which takes the food to the stomach, which is the J-shaped sac-like region. Next is the curved C-shaped part, which is the duodenum. The duodenum leads to the next part, that is the jejunum, and the jejunum leads to the ileum. These three structures, duodenum, jejunum and ileum, together form the small intestine. Next, the ileum then leads to the cecum. Cecum then forms the colon, and then the rectum, which is the location where the undigested food is temporarily stored. So here cecum, colon and rectum together forms the parts of the large intestine. The undigested food from the rectum then passes out through the anus. Let's now label the accessory glands. The salivary glands are located in the oral cavity and they release their secretion for digestion in the mouth. The liver is the largest gland in our body, and there is the gallbladder which stores the secretion of the liver, that is the bile. Pancreas are the complete glands that have all enzymes for digesting the food materials. These glands together forms the accessory glands of the digestive system. The appendix is a part which is considered to be a vestigial organ in our digestive system. All the other parts, that is the buccal cavity, the esophagus, stomach, small intestine and large intestine, form the alimentary canal, that is the parts through which the food passes, and it receives secretions from the accessory glands. So this is the human digestive system.